We have an update now on a story we've been reporting here on Studio 11, the dangers of a form of marijuana called wax. Some call it honey oil. It can get you high, but it can also get you killed or very badly injured. Phil Schumann's here to explain what we mean by that. Phil.
Well, that's because to make this so-called wax, you need to use a flammable, volatile liquid, typically butane or lighter fluid. Combine that with a spark and you've got an explosion and a fire. One doctor we talked with calls it a near epidemic. And a warning, some of these photos show the painful reality of what burns look like. Graphic evidence of the dangers of wax, a pure form of marijuana obtained when the leaves are soaked in butane, distilling the active chemical ingredient THC into a paste nicknamed wax or butter or honey oil. The danger comes in the homemade labs where it's made. All you need is a spark and the butane vapors explode into fire.
There was a time when we hear about an explosion in the house, our first concern was that of a meth lab or other hazardous condition. And nowadays our first reaction is there a honey oil operation going on?
At least 16 patients seen at burn centers like this one just in Southern California since the beginning of the year. Is this a growing problem? Absolutely.
This is becoming almost of epidemic proportions. We're finding more of this than we are meth lab explosions because it's more accessible.
Dr. Peter Grossman of the Grossman Burn Center at West Hills Hospital provided us with these images of a wax burn patient undergoing one of numerous operations to repair burns over more than half his body.
There's nothing worse than pain from a burn.
Pain from a burn acutely is horrific.
After he saw our earlier coverage on this subject, he wanted to sound an alarm.
Young people can manufacture this hash oil in their homes with very little equipment. The problem is they ignore how dangerous this is and how flammable the substance that they use to extract this oil, the butane, is.
But like so many dangerous things, the attraction apparently outweighs the risk. One wax maker explained what it's all about to us, as long as we didn't reveal his identity.
You obtain more THC when you smoke it. Seeing as wax is very strong, it gives you like kind of like a harsh punch in the chest feeling.
A punch in the chest feeling. It's something Ray Lozano has heard before.
I am now a little THC cell, okay? I just been smoked and I'm in the bloodstream.
Lozano's a drug and alcohol counselor who travels the country speaking to young people. For him, wax is a relatively new and scary trend.
The use of it is growing, because I know that it's in California. We're starting to see it in Nevada quite a bit, and it's making its way to the middle states. My message that I give out, it's really detrimental, especially long-term.
Long-term damage to the brain, debatable by medical experts. Damage to the body, no doubt.
Think about this. This is not worth the risk factor to get high for a few moments or to make a few dollars by selling this. Could very easily affect the rest of your life. And it's not just your life. It's people around you. It's the homes that tend to be destroyed because people are doing this in their home.
Right.
It's a very, very dangerous process.
Now, wax or honey oil or concentrates, it goes by different names, is actually legal to buy in medical marijuana dispensaries, though not all of them sell it. Presumably, their manufacturing process is a few more safeguards than those homemade wax labs we're talking about. Jeff, Laura?
Yeah. Phil, question for you. There's always a segment of the population that's just going to do it anyway. They won't listen, but is there any evidence that the word is starting to get out and maybe the demand's going down at all?
In fact, just the opposite. They're seeing more and more incidents of these, particularly in the West Coast. And as you heard from that Ray Lozano, who travels the country, he said that he's starting to see it more in the Midwest and some of the Southeast states as well.
Well, those pictures were terrifying. Is there any sense that the word is getting out about how dangerous this actually can be? We know that meth labs proliferated along much of Southern California.
Well, there's a lot of information on the internet, of course, and there are some warnings about the danger. But again, as we've been talking about, people are willing to take the risk. They always think it's never going to happen to me. They're careless. They're high. They're not paying attention. And especially if they're inside, one spark and it's an explosion.
All right. Phil Schumann in the newsroom. Phil, thanks very much.
Thank you so much.